All right, so welcome back to this episode of China Parts Strike Back. Today, we're gonna take a look at some of them China parts. Now, I've been chasing some coolant leaks, and first part of it, I got that solved, but then that showed me that there was another part unsolved. So we're gonna take a look at that today. So let's just get going on this thing, because this is holding me up and I don't want to get onto other things. So let's get rolling. So when we first got this thing running, I had a pretty slow leak right above the transmission bell housing and kinda didn't really like it. It was just a slow drip, but it was a constant slow drip. So that made me start tearing into this thing, and I took off the plate on the side. That is, of course, a Chinese piece, and kind of straightened up its sealing. So it started sealing better, but I also noticed one interesting part that leads to another leaking part. So let me just grab an original part and see what I'm talking about. All right, so this is the device that used to be on the side of the engine. It had your coolant exit and your EGR valve and a bunch of other wonderful stuff. So on the back side, this is exhaust gas coming from the cylinder, runs to this EGR valve, and when it opens up, you get exhaust gases out of here, which then feed into the intake. And on the intake section, you get your exhaust coming out of here, and it feeds down in the whole EGR manifold and warms everything up in the intake. Great for stock vehicles, not so great for making things less complicated. But by trying to make things less complicated, I made things more complicated. But anyways, I had noticed that I had water coming out of the EGR block off, which I thought was kind of strange at the moment, but I thought maybe it was leaking from other spots because the plate was whacked. But as I later find out, the intake is leaking. So what it's doing is the intake is leaking into the exhaust port for that EGR section and was dumping water here, which this wasn't exactly sealed on the plate because it doesn't have to be, but I was getting water leaking out of there. So that's where I was running into the issue. There's a little bit of water that was just coming out of there that shouldn't have been there, but yeah. So the plate probably would have been fine. I sealed it up even better, so hey, it's even better sealed. But now we have to tackle the intake section. So what I'm guessing is our intake manifold might not be perfectly flat. Either that or the side of our head might not be perfectly flat. But my money is on the Chinese intake here. So I'm going to yank that thing off, the thin little metal gasket is probably not enough for the weirdity of it. So we're just going to inspect it and see what we can do with it. I got most everything unfastened, so I just need to pull our fuel rail off, let the E85 leak everywhere, because that's what we do. Then we can just unplug our injectors. Get this last guy off of here. That should be good enough. And then we just yank this guy out of here. Okay, so it looks like right off the bat, we take a look at our wonderful intake here, and here's the port there. This is no EGR, so it's just blocked off there. But if you can see this ring here, for some reason, this cutout is not cut out the same as what's on the head. So either they jacked something up and didn't align the ports, because as you can see, there's just this tiny little spot there that's allowing water to leak behind. So once you get that water leaking behind, it can leak all the way through there. So that's a real bummer case. What we're probably gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to make a new gasket. Since we're not having any water coolant coming through here, we don't need any of that. So we'll just make a simple manifold that goes, or a simple thingy that goes across there. We'll block off all these tiny little coolant ports that were for the manifold preheating stuff. So yeah, guess we were just start going down that line and see where we end up to after that. All right, so after a little while with the razor blade, we cut out some Karapak. This should work pretty decent. I haven't had this really fail me much. So we're gonna coat this with some copper stuff, let it cure up and mount this thing up, and hopefully we'll be at least done with the leaking, which will be nice for me. All right, so just as simple as that, we just gotta dry off that port a little bit. Slide this guy in. Right, back in it goes. All right, so we got her topped off with liquid again. We'll have to tighten down that. I need to So that's probably going to do it for today. We at least got one thing accomplished. It doesn't leak anymore. Everything's nice and bone dry. So we are sitting good there. We can move on to something else. I don't know what that something else is, because we're almost done here, at least with phase one. We still gotta get it running just a tad bit better, but as it is right now, we could probably idle it down the street or whatever. But I'd like to get a little throttled response out of it so it doesn't like choke, but we're not doing too bad. We probably need to get timing and get it timed in properly, but that's something for something later. Anyways, thank you for stopping by and watching. Hopefully you're subscribed so you can see some more of this stuff when we catch you again later.